Hey everyone, I know I promised that I was gonna answer some questions for you with Leatherback Sea Turtles, and I didn't forget, I just couldn't find the PowerPoint presentation. I thought I made it on Google Slides, but I made it on my PowerPoint. It was on my desktop, and when I was making plans for this week, I found it. So here's just a little brief discussion. You had two questions that I asked you. Why do you think the female sea turtles look like she's crying, and why is she throwing sand all over the place? So the leatherback sea turtles rarely come out during the day. This is a really rare picture. She's probably almost done laying her eggs. She comes up, I think, every 14 days and lays a bushel, about 100 eggs. And she does that several times throughout the season. Only female sea turtles come out out of the water. The male sea turtles actually stay up in the North Atlantic, and the females make the journey down. It's really rare that sea turtles go as far north as leatherback sea turtles, but they're quasi-endothermic because of the structure of their body. Also, they don't have bones. They only have cartilage. So if you sat on the sea turtle, it's a pretty good chance that you would take her out. You would probably crush her. She wouldn't be able to breathe. So if you notice, though, she's got gook around her eyes. She's got sand all over her body. So we're going to determine why that happens. Here's the island that I worked on, which was St. Croix. It was probably one of the greatest jobs that I ever had. Basically, because you work at night. So I would hang out during the day on the beach. My bathing was the ocean. And then I would fall asleep, go to a 12 o'clock meeting. And then I would then get to work for the rest of the night. And here's where I worked, which was Sandy Point, which is now a national wildlife refuge. Here are the biologists that I worked with. That's what they looked like when I worked with them. This is what they look like today. So that's Scott and Karen Eckert. So right here, they're measuring the carapace of the sea turtle. And if you look right about here, they would band them. So we would know when they would come up. This guy right here is catching eggs as they come out. It's pretty disgusting, actually, catching sea turtle eggs. So then you would take some detailed information, write it down, collect the eggs if you have to collect the eggs. So if this was a beach where we know it would get destroyed later in the year, we would move her eggs so they would hatch. Then we would measure the nest and the depth, and we'll talk about that later. Here's just an example of her crying. So why are sea turtles crying? Sea turtles cry because they have a high salt diet. Everything they eat is in the ocean, mostly jellyfish. So they have to get rid of the salt water, the salt content somehow. So if they were in the water, this would naturally be flowing out. If you notice around here, you could see that her throat is really, really red. She's just trying to expel heat because she weighs a ton, like literally weighs a ton, or half a ton at least. And she's carrying all that weight, and she's really, really hot, even though it's cool at night. So she's trying to expel that heat somehow. And here, she's throwing sand all over the place. So when predators come, they can't find the nest. Now, if you look, they're collecting the eggs, so those eggs would be moved to a safe place. The female goes into like a catatonic state when she starts laying eggs. So you can pretty much do whatever you want to tag her, measure her, take her eggs. Once she comes out of that catatonic state, she's kind of brutal and quite violent and can do some damage. Here's her laying eggs. This is not a leatherback sea turtle, by the way, but it's the best picture. So you would count the clutch. And again, you would measure it across and measure it at depth. And one of the reasons that we did that was it was determined that reptiles' sex isn't genetic, isn't determined by genetics. It's determined by temperature. So all that time that they were putting sea turtle eggs into styrofoam containers and keeping them at one climate, they may have created a whole generation of sea turtles that were one sex. So think about that. Here she goes. She's leaving. All right. Again, look at the red neck. She's got some tears coming down. She's heading towards the shore, and she'll be back in 14 days. They're not really sure why leatherback sea turtles have this little red thing on the top of their head. Maybe they do by now. It's been a while since I studied sea turtles, but at the time they thought it was some type of light sensor, a directional compass of some sort. And here's an example of what a sea turtle will do to cover her tracks, no pun intended. So the predator doesn't know where to start digging. Here's kind of a sad picture. So here are the numbers of leatherbacks, their nesting sites since 1982. And if you look, they're quite low, okay? So St. Croix isn't on here, but if you really look at along the Pacific East, which would be on the other side of the ocean, on the other side of, not California, right? No, that's California. Pacific East is technically California, in Mexico and on and on and on. South America, look how the numbers have crashed. Okay, now they were threatened when I studied them back in the day. I'm not going to tell you when it was because then you'd figure out how old I am. But they weren't in this much of danger when I was studying them, and they were quite endangered at the time. So I hope this was entertaining and helpful. Hope you watched it, and I hope you know a little bit more about sea turtles.